it's not the first heartbroken. My eyes are not the first to cry. I'm not the first to know. There's just no getting over you. Just a fool who's willing to sit around and wait for you. But baby, can't you see?
Thank you. Thank you. Good evening, everyone. I would like to welcome all of you, the parents and family members that are here today, to celebrate this special event, the Greendale Middle School Farewell Assembly for the 2022 eighth grade graduates. This is our second time holding the Farewell Assembly outdoors, and we could not have asked for a better day to recognize our eighth grade students. I want to say a special thank you to the staff at Greendale High School for all of their help and support and allowing us to use Gavinsky Stadium to hold this outdoor event. At this time, I ask all of you to please rise for the playing of the Star Spangled Banner performed by our eighth grade concert band under the direction of Ms. Sam Kovach. Eighth grade band members, please assemble. Thank you, Ms. Kovach, and the members of the eighth grade band. At this time, students, please be seated. Again, I would like to welcome all of you to the 8th grade farewell assembly. My name is John Weiss, and I am fortunate to be principal at Greendale Middle School, and I want to thank all of you for attending today. This is a very important day in the lives of these young people sitting in front of us today, and for all of you as well, as this group of students now makes the transition from the middle school to the high school. Today is an opportunity for them to come together one last time as a middle school class to celebrate as a full group all that they have accomplished during their time at Greendale Middle School. I am grateful that we have the opportunity to come together after what certainly has been a unique middle school experience for all of these students. There are certainly many adjectives that we could use to describe what these 8th grade students have experienced during their 3 years at GMS, but I think the word unique is a good word to describe this one-of-a-kind or like no other experience for this 8th grade class. While challenging, there are certainly so many positives that we can take away from this and a lot to be proud of. There is a quote by Nelson Mandela that I used with the GMS staff this year. The quote is, "It always seems impossible until it is done." This quote can certainly be used to describe the perseverance that this 8th grade group demonstrated during their middle school years. Before I continue my message to the students, I want to take a moment for some recognition and to say some thank yous. I'd like to take a moment to recognize Ms. Emily Doe, Associate Principal at Greendale Middle School. Your creativity, care, and leadership help to provide students with the social and academic support they need. I appreciate all of your work, your positive approach, and the passion you exhibit each day to provide the students with a meaningful middle school experience. Thank you, Ms. Doe. Thank you to the entire staff at Greendale Middle School. I am fortunate to work with individuals that truly understand what it takes to give our students their very best every day. These last few years have required our staff to do things that were completely new, all in an effort to provide our students with the best experience possible. GMS is full of individuals who work together to have an impact on the lives of so many students and understand the responsibility they have of ensuring that all our students have a positive school experience. Thank you for your continued devotion to the students and your hard work to teach to the whole child. And I want to say thank you to you, the parents, family, and friends that are here today. I have been part of the Greendale School District now for over 25 years, and these last 3 years, more than any other, we asked a lot of you. These middle school years are not always easy, and you have played such an important role in helping your child navigate through this unique middle school experience. Thank you for the trust and support you provide us, and I hope your child appreciates all that you have done for them, even if that appreciation comes a little later in life. And finally, to the students, this last part of my speech is for you. Every year I take some time over the Memorial Day weekend to sit outside on my patio and I reflect on the group of 8th grade students that we are now sending to the high school, and I think about the experience that you had at the middle school. This year was no different. I took advantage of some nice weather and reflected on your experiences and the impact that you had on our school. Today you have reached the end of your middle school experience, and I would like to congratulate each and every one of you. The part that is special about today is that we are not just recognizing one individual, we are celebrating the unique journey that all of you made as a collective group. This is an exciting day, and I could not be happier for you. A few weeks ago, I attended my son's graduation from UWN. And the commencement speech was given by William Dafoe, a well-known actor from Appleton, Wisconsin. Most of you probably know him as the Green Goblin from Spider-Man. There was one piece of his speech that struck me as I thought about my message to this 8th grade class. Mr. Dafoe started his speech by telling the graduates that the advice he was given whenever addressing a group is that if you try to reach everyone with your message, you will reach no one. But if you try to reach one, you will reach everyone. So I use that advice to focus my message on one piece that I think is valuable for all of us here today. At Greendale Middle School, we place emphasis on the key attributes that we believe will help students to be successful, not only in school, but beyond. At the top of the list of these attributes is character. Your character is what's going to define you, who you are as an individual, and the impact that you will have on others. When I had the opportunity to meet with most of you in May of 2019, when you came for the visit to the middle school as fifth grade students, one of the things that I stressed was the importance of making a good first impression and treating each other with respect and kindness. What we didn't know at the time was the unique experiences that awaited you during your middle school years, and the multiple ways you were going to be asked to engage with your teachers and other students to make that first impression and demonstrate respect and kindness. For each of you, your interactions with others took place behind masks, socially distanced, at assigned spaces, in classrooms that had half the number of students, or in a virtual environment that required you to spend your day in a Google Meet. The experiences you faced since March of your sixth grade year required you to demonstrate a whole new level of respect and kindness for others. In addition to this being a new experience for all of us, the challenges that others faced were different for each individual. We all learned quickly that in order for us to be successful in this unique situation, showing respect and kindness to each other was going to be needed if we were going to get through this together. This was not always easy, but as I referenced earlier, it always seems impossible until it is done. And now you have the opportunity to take your experiences from the last 3 years, the perseverance you demonstrated through some very challenging times, and the understanding of how we need to treat each other with respect and kindness to continue to explore your passion and make your mark on this world. Do the right things and think about how you are treating people in every situation. The classroom, the hallways, in the lunchroom, on the sports field, at a marching band competition, or any of the multiple activities you will be involved in. Always be respectful and kind. People will notice. I am confident that this ability to persevere in the face of challenges and change will have its benefits moving forward. You have all gone through a middle school experience like no other, but you did it together. As a group, I hope that you valued the friendships that you have created over the years and you continue to support each other. Continue to understand the importance of being able to persevere and support each other in all situations. Always remember to respect each other and accept each other's individual differences. Support each other when you see someone needs your help. Challenge yourself to be the best that you can be. Take advantages of the opportunities that await you. Be the leaders that I know you can be. And most importantly, be yourself. I am confident that the experiences you had at Greendale Middle School and your ability to persevere during these unique 3 years will serve you well as you start your journey into high school together. Thank you, and again, congratulations. At this time, I would like to introduce two of our eighth grade students, Zaid Cartagena and Lucy Mermel, who will be representing this class this year to say a few words to all of you.
On top and Lucy's right underneath. As we enter the last period of our childhood, it is important to notice the stepping stones and accomplishments we as a 2026 graduating class have made. The global pandemic and day-to-day struggles have truly challenged our limits. Whether the limits are on our academics, mental health, physical health, or our social lives, all of us experience the same thing in many different ways. Whatever boundaries new world has set for us, we are in this to grow, learn, and mature. And it is exemplary to understand that every challenge is something to welcome with open arms. Challenges make us stronger in any aspect of our lives, and it is only understandable to tackle freshman year and the rest of our high school career under this thought. Having the end and majority of our sixth and seventh grade years be behind the screen has surely humbled us. Personally, I had trouble connecting with what I was learning and the people who were around me, and I'm sure many felt the same way. For the people that thrive virtually, though, I give you full props because it was not easy. The virtual environment we learned in during this time period has shown that not only can we overcome, but we can maintain a healthy and consistent learning effort. At times, I'm sure not every single one of us students has shown an interest in what we're learning at the moment, but the knowledge that we gained from middle school was and will still prove to be important in our lives. As I said before, the disheveled and thrown around nature of the last few years can seriously affect our readiness for the next big hurdle that high school is. I think one thing as a class that we need to remember is that we are the only people in charge of our path and our potential. As you've probably already heard from your parents countless times, the effort you put in affects the outcome that you can get out. However much you don't want to do that last math assignment or the project you have to present the next hour, you have to put forth your best effort. Because regardless, you're going to have to do it one way or another. In conclusion, our years in middle school were not easy, and the next years aren't going to be easy as well. Although we hope not to have another global pandemic that shuts down our school, other challenges will continue to show up. Difficult situations are a part of life, and there's no way around it. We have proven and have to persist the fact that we are strong enough to prevail over these difficult defiances.
When we stepped into our elementary schools for the first time, we didn't know what to expect. I remember we'd always stare up at the fifth graders with awe and dream of the days when that would be us. And after what seemed like an eternity, it was. We were finally the fifth graders. We were the big kids of the school, and everything was so simple. But unlike elementary school, the start of sixth grade was much more chaotic. We had to worry about locker combinations, finding our classes, trying to always be on time, and constantly checking our emails. It was very overwhelming, and many of us thought we could never get used to it. But just like elementary school, it all became normal again. And it stayed that way until COVID hit. Then, for the rest of the year, and for the first time in most of our lives, we had to start learning from home. Then, we started seventh grade, not knowing how the year would turn out. We ended up having to shift between virtual school, in-person days, and frequently, but annoyingly, getting quarantined all the time. But in the end, we managed. Before we knew it, we were in eighth grade, and no matter how hard things got this year, we always adjusted. So before I continue, I wanted to say congratulations, because not only this year, but in sixth and seventh grade too, we have worked so hard through everything that has been thrown at us. So remember to be proud of what you've accomplished, because it definitely wasn't easy. During our middle school journey, we have learned many things and have made countless friends and memories along the way. We also want to thank you to all of our teachers, friends, family, for the support you gave, the things you pushed to achieve, and the memories you helped to create. We wouldn't be here without you. And if you think about it, we will never have a normal or average middle school experience. But as a result of this, we have been able to connect with our peers in a way no one else has. These special bonds and experiences we have had will be more important than ever as we make our way into high school. It will definitely be challenging for us to adjust again, but school is just another hurdle in the long track that makes up our lives. Although it will be sad to leave behind middle school, we have to move on to accomplish greater things. And as someone once said, Don't cry because it's over. Smile because it happened. And as an eighth grade class, we want to thank Mr. Weiss for being our principal for these past 3 years.
Hold on 1 minute. Probably would have pulled a hamstring trying to get that. First of all, I want to say thank you to the eighth grade class, and I especially want to thank Zaid and Lucy for their wonderful speeches. What a great way to represent the eighth grade class. At this time, I would like to ask the members of the 8th grade orchestra to please assemble for their playing of a Miley Cyrus popular tune under the direction of Mr. Jim Hebby.
I saw it. It went up.
Enjoy it.
All right, I want to say thank you to the members of our 8th grade orchestra and to Mr. Hebby. At this time, we are now going to hear a recording of the song, Have It All, that is performed by our 8th grade choir under the direction of Miss Emily Roble. At this time, would the members of the 8th grade choir please stand to be recognized?
And causes of success. May you have the confidence to always do your best. May you take no effort in your being generous, sharing what you can, nothing more, nothing less. May you know the meaning of the word happiness. May you always leave from the beating in your chest. May you be treated like an esteemed guest. May you get to rest, may you catch your breath. And may the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. May the road less paved be the road that you follow. Well, here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna change. Here's to the infinite possible ways to love you. I want you to have it. Here's to the good times we're gonna have. You don't need money, you got free pass. Here's to the fact that I'd be sad without you. I want you to have it all. I want you to have it all. I want you to have it. I want you to have it all. May you be as fascinating as a slap bracelet. May you keep the chaos and the clutter off your desk. May you have unquestionable health and less stress. Having no possessions, no immeasurable wealth. May you get a gold star on your next test. May your educated guesses always be correct. And may you win prizes shining like diamonds. May you really honor each moment to the next. And may the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. Whoa. And may the road less paved be the road that you follow. Whoa. Well, here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna change. Here's to the infinite possible ways to love you. I want you to have it. Here's to the good times we're gonna have. You don't need money, you got free pass. Here's to the fact that I'd be sad without you. I want you to have it all. I want you to have it all. I want you to have it. I want you to have it all.
Thank you to our choir students and to Ms. Roble. At this time, I would like to welcome Dr. Kimberly Amidzik, superintendent of the Greendale School District, for her message to the students. I want to thank Dr. Amidzik for all of her leadership and support this school year. I have had the pleasure of working with Dr. Amidzik for many years, and I appreciate all she has done to navigate us through these last few unique school years. Dr. Amidzik, thank you for taking the opportunity to address this wonderful group of students.
Good evening. Thank you, Mr. Weiss. I appreciate both the introduction, and I'm grateful for your leadership at Greendale Middle School over the past 14 plus years. I won't say how long we worked together because that might reveal my age. All right. It is incredibly exciting to be able to welcome everyone to Kavinsky Stadium this evening for a more normal version of our traditions and celebrations. I use the word normal in quotation marks because normal is relative, and normal evolves over time. What was normal for your parents or your siblings or the graduating classes who preceded you are not necessarily the normal for the Greendale High School graduating class of 2026. Since before you were born, your parents began planning for your future. Your families had hopes and dreams for you and ideas about what your life would be like. They likely made many decisions about where to live, where to send you to school, and what activities to sign you up for. They have made food choices and healthcare decisions. Throughout your journey so far, they have held your hand and shared their wisdom. These became the expectations for normal in your journey and your life. The last 2 years have been unpredictable and unsettling, particularly for the adults who care about you. We have worried about how you will grow and learn. We have worried about how the experiences will change your opportunities, and the changes have been hard on all of us. But you are resilient, you are strong, and you are becoming increasingly independent with your own ideas about your future. I was talking with a parent recently who told me that his children had developed skills that would not have developed without the push of the pandemic. Rising ninth graders, you have developed some new skills throughout middle school with accelerated growth this year. Character, as Mr. Weiss mentioned, is the attribute at the center of the attributes of a Greendale graduate. Character in this context includes independence, understanding of others, and valuing learning. Over your years at Greendale Middle School, you have had numerous opportunities to develop these skills and demonstrate your growth and character. This attribute and the skills of time management, self-advocacy, and taking responsibility to make productive choices that define independence with the attribute of character will serve you well as you begin your high school career. You see, your family and your teachers have given you the tools. In a sentiment often attributed to Mother Teresa, they can teach you how to fly, but you won't fly their flight. They can teach you to dream, but you won't live their dreams. They can teach you how to live, but you will not live their life. Nevertheless, in every flight, in every life, and in every dream, the imprint of the way you were taught will remain. As you begin your final 4 years in the Greendale schools, I hope you will continue to foster your independence and take responsibility for your actions and your choices. At the same time, always know that your families, your teachers, and your community will be here to support you and guide you on your journey. We will continue to help you find ways to pursue your dreams and live the life you choose to build for yourself. Congratulations to you, the graduating class of 2026, and I look forward to welcoming you to Greendale High School in the fall.
Thank you, Dr. Amidzik. At this time, we will now begin the awarding of the eighth grade diplomas. Ms. Doe will be announcing the name of the students in alphabetical order by row, and the students will be coming to the front and walking the stage to receive their diplomas.
Ready? Hattie Abukamira. David Atomovich. Aiden Acevedo. Connor Adams. Naminia Eider. Mackay Akins. Benin Al-Sudani. Benin El-Tikriti. Ali Al-Jayusi. Kylie Allison. Gianna Anaya. Lydia Anderson. Cecilia Ortega. Elsie Ayala. Amber Belota. Gavin Berry. Kyla Bassler. Gabriella Bauer. Jacob Benali. Brian Bullock. Valerie Brockman. Annabelle Brilo. Jude Bunzel. Isabella Burnett. Isaac Campbell. Sophia Carini. Zaid Cartagena. Xavier Castillo. Blas Serta. Maya Saraceras. Mark Chula. Aubrey Cook. Miles Cotton. Alfonso Crespo Badul. Neilani Crespo Walbe. Noah Crosby. Audrey Cullen. Tegan Zarneska. Alex Danbeck. Nolan Din. Lucas Dobbs. Braden Delkowitz. William Doyle.
Glenbard.
Peyton Dunn. Jocelyn DeRocher. Adela Ecker. Tatiana Edwards. Liliana Eland. Tobias Ely. Isabella Enter. Andrew Farmer. Muhammad Ali Farouk. Dylan Flink. Lily Frick Mahout. Noel Fuentes. Leonardo Gamboa. Peter Geitman. Lila Gibson. Lauren Gilbert. Martin Golden. Easton Grzalski. Jack Griffin. Jack Grunsky. Thomas Hanlon. Beckham Hansen. Brandon Harper. Nico Hartman. Hayden Heisey. Martin Henning. Jacob Hick. Kira Hickey. Lydia Hill. Emma House. Amir Howard. Vivian Wang. Lauren Huberty. Raymond Johnson. Sue Johnson. Deanna Johnston. Isabella Jopek. Caitlin Keltner. Maya Kling. Jaden Knapp. Daniel Knopik. Melanie Koloff. Kaylee Qualkey. Chloe Kringle. Keith Kubacki. Merrick Cuny. Casey Lamb. Sebastian Legenfeld. Bentley Larson. Sophie Lattis. Kaya Leach. Phineas Lee. Michaela Lewitsky. Sean Liebel. Gabrielle Leeson. Silas Limbert. Sophia Linares. Wenny Liu. Cole Lofi. Noah Lofi. Tyler Lopez. David Lunar. Jid O'Malley. Lily Manders. Josie Marshall. Frank Martinez. Elizabeth Massetti. Zachary McNulty. Lucy Mermel. Zane Morris. Robert Munoz. Emma Mae Nadelhoffer. Emily Nelson. Maren Nolan. Marquise Norris. Logan Nowak. Austin Pacanella. Ella Padron. Anj Parangia. Giselle Pasquitz. Raina Patel. Addison Patnaud. Shayla Pavlicek. Gavin Perez. Jack Perleberg. Gavin Peterson. Bennett Peterson. James Pinkolic. Ahmad Kasem. Liliana Ramos. Kaylin Reese. Naima Revolinsky. Matthew Ritter. Lucas Reichert. Tyler Roach. Chase Rulin. Acer Saddledean. Hayden Sagler. Nadia Salem. Matthew Songer. Alexander Sandroni. Sydney Shep. Camden Schilling. Colin Traven. Eden Shook. Morgan Selhausen. Riley Settle. Hannah Shaban. Azmi Shahada. Charlie Sheridan. Hassan Siddiqui. Gracelyn Slack. Fire Smart. Bailey Soto Flores.
Miss Lowe, what's your favorite?
Cole Spada. Macy St. Lawrence. Ian Stalker. Brandon Stege. Jacob Stelter. Matthew Strobel. Ava Sula. Autumn Tabora. Maya Togger. Jake Tesh. Noah Thompson. Samara Trudell. Elijah Van Heesch. Adeline Van Rue. Haley Vasquez Otora. Clea Walters. Saad Wakaz. Deacon Ward. Annabella Weber. Anders Weishan. Spencer Wenlick. Dane Wenzel. Jonathan Wierzbicki. Braden Wilde. Christopher Wilkinson. Grace Witinski. Lincoln Witinski. Avery Zhang. Peyton Yoder. Haley Zaradnik. Catherine Zarling. Laurel Zai. Xavier Zimmerman.
How about another round of applause for our eighth grade graduates? So I want to congratulate all of our eighth grade graduates and hope that their next 4 years are successful and rewarding. This is a great class, and Greendale Middle School is going to miss you. A reminder that the eighth grade farewell dance will begin at 7:30 until 9 o'clock in the GMS MPR. And I'd also like to remind the parents of the opportunity for a marquee photo op. There are still some available slots, so feel free to sign up. And one last time before we leave the stadium, one more round of applause for our graduating class of 2022.